to do so too many steps to get one thing working, unless I'm very like over how do you say, like over fixated on fixing it, like it has to work. Now if I cannot fix it like quick now, at least for art, I just want to open the program and work. And for some reason, PaintSci offered me that solution, and Photoshop didn't. Photoshop was like, nah, we're not working with your tablets. It's old, you know. And it wasn't even that old of a tablet. It was a Wacom, Intuos pen. It wasn't even a Bamboo. I think Bamboo is their older model of the same one I had. Nope, they were like, nah, your tablet is from like 2008. We only work with tablets that are from 2010 onward, kind of attitude on the program itself, not Photoshop, the company. But that was kind of annoying, having to set up every single time I open the program. And it would say that it would save those settings, but it didn't. For some reason, it did not. And I just got pissed off over time. I was like, I'm not dealing with this anymore. So, when I started using PaintSci, like the moment I opened the program, it started working. So, I'm like, why? Why is this program that is like not even one-fifth of the price of what I was paying for Photoshop, right? This little tiny program that is being made by one single person has the solution to my problem like immediately. And I've heard and I've seen people that still use Photoshop. You know, I'm not denying it's a great program and it does so many things. The problem with Photoshop itself is that it doesn't know what it's gonna be. Like, it started as a photo editing software and then it delved into design program and photo editing program, and now it's kind of like a mixture of animation and 2D and photo editing, and you know, it's just a mixture of all these things all together. And to where the program itself is too heavy. They did create Adobe Illustrator to separate the design part to make like a fully vector only program on Illustrator later on, but they still kept a few tools in Photoshop, which is okay. It's okay because I know that they're, if they were to take out all the illustration stuff from Photoshop, a lot of artists would get pissed off because, you know, there are tools that you kind of need, even if you're gonna use that vector tool and turn it into a pixel, you rasterize it later on, you know, people need it. And it's understandable if they keep it, but I would have taken Clip Studio's approach when it comes to all the tools they have, because Clip Studio gives you the program itself with a little tutorial on how to use it, and the little tutorial is kind of lacking. With the amount of things that you can do at Clip Studio right now, the tutorial they give you is kind of lacking. But the point I want to make is Clip Studio itself knows what it wants to be. Like when you first install the program. What is this? Why do I have two of these? Oh, just. I'm confused. Why did I have two of these? Anyway, Clip Studio knows what to present itself as, which is an art program, right? It's for you, the artist, to use for both either editing pictures or drawing from scratch, and they present themselves as that. I'm so smart, I forgot to turn off the symmetry tool. There you go. Anyway, so Clip Studio, when you first install it, it's very lacking. All the nice tools that you see all these popular artists use, you have to download them, but you don't have to go through a third party like Photoshop was letting you do. Like, I'm not against third party, but the fact that I don't have to like scour the internet to find that little tool that my friend talked about and is kind of obscure, you know, And instead, I just have it directly added to this little store that Clip Studio has. Like, Clip Studio has a little store where anyone pretty much can upload their little brushes, their little tools, and their little things that help with art, you know? And there's so many things that you can do in Clip Studio right now. But thing is, like, you install the program and it doesn't have everything, because all the stuff, all the nice stuff, were created by users and it is in their store. But the point I want to make is, when you install Clip Studio, it's so easy and it's so intuitive that you don't have to worry about all those millions of buttons that Photoshop has. Photoshop has hidden menus that you have to look for tutorials on how to do certain things to be like, oh, I didn't know that it had this. You know, and even on their own little personalized tutorials that they make, it's still lacking. They don't know their own program at this point. It has too many things to where it's not welcoming for new people, you know. And yeah, I personally would not recommend Photoshop for a newcomer. Unless, and let me repeat this, unless you want to work for a big company, okay? Because if you want to work as an independent artist, to be honest, Clip Studio and Paint-O-Sai have a structure that is very, very similar to Photoshop, right? And anything that you learn here, anything that you learn here, once you transfer to Photoshop, you're gonna see the same tools, very, very similar icons, and it makes learning Photoshop later on easier, because you have the basic idea of how things work. And also, if you didn't know, this might not apply to every computer, but if you don't have the money to buy Photoshop, there is this website called Photopia. I heard kind of like mixed stories about it. Like, oh, there's people that say, oh, Photopia is bad, Photopia is good. I don't know. I did not do my full research on why is Photopia good or bad. Give me just one sec. There's something that's bothering me here. But from my experience, the very little bit that I've learned about it has been pretty good. You know? It's been pretty energizing. I need some water. Let me get some sip. The character I'm working on right now is a commission from Twitter. And his name is Grazel. I did all the design yesterday. It was so much fun because I was just playing around, chit-chatting with friends. You guys are not gonna believe it, but yesterday I was laughing my ass off over soccer on stream. Soccer, like when, how? But somehow my friends who were watching who were watching the stream, they were all of them brought up this name of What's the name of the game? Let me remember. PES. I say PES. I don't know if you say PES or PES, but two friends of mine were like, oh my goodness, this person that makes a commentary on that does the commentary on the soccer game, he's so funny. And I was like, huh, really? Like, because I remember my older brother had that game, but I never paid attention to the guy that makes a commentary, like, whether or not it's funny or not, right? So I was kind of doubtful, and then they sent me this video. It was so funny. The way that the guy expresses himself and the way that he, like, celebrates whenever someone makes a goal is so funny. It's in Spanish, though, because otherwise I would have played it here. And the reason why I played something in Spanish yesterday is because pretty much the only people watching were they, those two friends of mine. And they were practicing their English with me, which was good. I'm proud of them for practicing their English. And, okay. That is weird. Give me 1 second. Sick. Where did I leave my okay? I had to be a bee. I'll be here quickly. It's gonna be like literally 30 seconds. I got my thing. My thing. Nothing. All right, I'm back. Just my nose is itchy for some reason. I don't know. All right. Alright, I'm back. Hello! Welcome! My name is Bunny. Okay, we got this one colored. Let's do this one. What I'm doing right now is picking the shape. Like, I use select and I clean up this stuff like this, like just by clicking pixel by pixel, picking up the right pixels and the spots where I don't want the color to go. The blue is where I don't want the color to go. And then I invert it because the white part is where the color is not gonna go, technically, because blue is selected. So I just erase everything on blue, then invert it, then boom, color. And then later on, I come back to this blob of one single color and add the other ones. Because you can lock a spot of color and paint inside of it without having to do the selection thing anymore. I really love that. So I just fill it in with one single color and then go through each one of them one by one again, painting the whole thing. Instead of trying to do all the work in one sitting, you just spread it in little tasks. That makes sense. It also works better with my ADHD to do one little thing at a time. And I really like this. I've been doing it this way for actually many years, actually. I've seen artists use this little tool, but it only works on Clip Studio. The little tool I'm talking about, what it does is it automatically looks for the line art, and once it finds it, it starts painting only inside the line art, which would have been actually good to have here, but, you know, I don't mind. Here you go. I'm sorry, it's just, it happened. I announced it yesterday. I said it was gonna happen, and it happened. If you check my stream from yesterday, there were parts on the stream that were muted because of music having copyright. And that's because this is my favorite artist, and I love his instrumentals. These are actually ripped, but, you know, because the songs have sections where he doesn't sing, the bot actually picks up on which songs these are, and they're like, oh, these are copyrighted, you cannot use them. And, I don't really mind, because, the money I make is not from the streams. So, if I have to be honest, if my streams ever get fully demonetized because I'm playing music for my favorite artist, it's not gonna affect me. I would be sad, I'm not gonna lie, but it's not gonna affect me to have my streams demonetized because I'm playing my favorite music. To be honest, I understand where they're coming from, like, especially if I'm gonna share this stream somewhere, they have to do it. And that is fine by me. I don't even have a YouTube channel or something where I would upload this and I would feel like, oh, this is good, you know. I'm curious about YouTube streaming. Hopefully someone shows up later on that I could ask about this. What, Dallas? What about Dallas? Don't tell me Dallas rigged up. Yep, Dallas review is, Dallas review. Okay, Dallas review. So, Dallas review, he's a YouTuber. And people are trying to get blocked by him. People are speedrunning blocks. Okay. That's funny. It's been a while since I last watched a video from Dallas Review. His videos are good. They're in Spanish, though. He's from Spain, obviously. He makes videos talking about pretty much anything that he thinks is fun or funny. sometimes even from like random websites, be like, oh, like architectural failures and stuff like that, you know, funny things. Or sometimes even serious stuff. Like he, in the beginning, he talked about the Blue Whale game, and then he started joking about the Blue Whale game, and that got him, I think, a video taken down because people were like, "Oh, this is insensitive," which is understandable. It's a game about suicide, but it was also figured out that it was the pages that were created after the scandal, they were all made for clout, and the videos that Dallas was making were all about that. It was all about, the videos that Dallas was making were all about making fun of these pages that were trying to emulate the whole Blue Whale game thing, trying to look edgy and stuff. Why are you for too long? What happened? I forgot the name of, I mean the name, the lyrics of the song. I wanted to, you know what I want to do? I want to do these videos for YouTube where I sit down and how do I say this? Like, right, I like talk about topics here, and then I just edit the audio later on and make a video about it. Like, for example, I would talk about the whole shoplifting at Walmart, for example, and maybe make a video about it. Because, like, if you guys didn't know, Walmart keeps track of you. They might not go to you if you steal something small, but their programs and their things have been set up in a way to where the people that work in security, they can see your face and they can take a picture of your face and they can even identify who you are. And they send a picture of your face to the nearest other Walmarts. Like, if there is more than one Walmart in your town, all of them are gonna know that you are a shoplifter. They're gonna not gonna do anything about it. If whatever you're shoplifting is cheap in value. For example, if you steal something like aspirin or medicine, tampons, you know, other stuff that are usually cheap or under $50 in price. So they just let you go. They're just like, oh, it's just stealing candy, you know. But that doesn't mean they're being nice. It means that they're keeping track of you, in the sense of they're keeping track of what you are stealing of. In terms of value, they keep up with that instead of trying to stop you. They say if they have a little archive where they add up whatever you have been stealing, and eventually, once you reach $500 of stolen goods, that is when they report you to police, because that is a felony. And instead of having to deal with shoplifters the easy way, they prefer to wait and hit you hard. They send you directly to jail, you know. And no one talks about it for some reason. It's a known thing, and people that work in security at Walmart have talked about it on both Reddit and other social media. They're like, yeah, this is real and this is true. And, you know, it's saddening, you know. From what I understood, like, they do follow the whole, statute of limitations thing. So, after some time, whatever you stole years ago, you know, gets taken out of the list. But if in the space of, I think it's 5 years, if in a time of 5 years, you manage to add up $500 of stolen goods, you, my friend, might be reported to police. You know, very, very likely to be reported to police by Walmart, so don't shoplift at Walmart. Like, in general, don't shoplift, but at least know that there's bigger stores do this kind of stuff, and that you're gonna end up in jail for shoplifting over small things. They add up, and you get to 500, you're gone. Who knows, And it's topics like this, like that I learn on my free time. When I'm just sitting down, scrolling on my phone, reading about the news, checking my social media and stuff. I would love to talk about the topics that get me interested, like crazy interested, because of my ADHD, I get hyper-focused on random topics. And I love to talk about it. I love to talk about it when I'm, like, recently informed about it. Let me see. I would like to have my Live 2D avatar again added to the stream later on. After I'm done with this one, I'm gonna go back into Live 2D because I finished a few details that I did not finish on stream yesterday. My husband was like, oh, I'm gonna take a nap, you can use the computer. Because what we do is we have one computer at home, right? And I have the computer for myself all morning. And when he gets home, he works on his YouTube videos and his video games. So he has the computer for himself for majority of the night, except on the nights that we decide on playing Fall Guys. Rotund. It's just a friend of mine shared a picture in a group. And he said, like, oh, that's a rotund kitty. It's a round kitty.
Thank you, come again. Thank you, come Ooh. Again.
Hello! That was fast. Thank you so much for the follow. That was so sweet. Thank you. I was literally just checking my phone for a few messages and that caught me off guard, not gonna lie. But thank you. Mwah. Thank you so much for the follow. Alright, I have finished the color stuff. Let me get into the... What am I listening to? What is this?
Thank you, come again. You come again.
Thank you! Thank you, come again! It's well appreciated. Thank you so much. Why did it play 3 times? I have no idea, but thank you so much for the follow. Let me actually see why did it play the... I only have sound alerts once on the stream. That is weird. Why did it play 3 times? I'm confused. Anyway, there's two Shumis on screen. That's funny. All right, let's check. So he has a little bit of orange on the ears and a little bit of orange here around the eyes. So let me do that. Did I pick up the orange? Oh yeah, yes I did. So let's do it with this guy. A little bit less. There you go. Here. And here. Let me make this a little bit bigger. There. That's better. Oh! What's going on? Why is it not doing it? Okay. Yeah. Alright, he has it on the... And on the ears. Let me make it, like, bigger here. Nice. That is so cool! I gotten like how many followers did I get right now? Like 2? That's sweet. Sadly they didn't subscribe, but it's okay. I mean not subscribe, they didn't chat. I said I'm still learning the, how do you say the lingo? The Twitch lingo, I'm still learning. Sadly they did not chat. I wish they chatted. So that I can have someone to talk to because I'm alone. I'm all alone on this stream. Oh, also, I wanted to check what is it that I'm listening to because it's a... Oh, okay. It's Adam Young's, I think it's called Scores or Excelsior. And Endurance, Apollo. Okay, gotcha. It's his, the music that he made for the project. I don't know if you guys heard about it. This was a contest that Adam Young, the person behind Owl City, made not so long ago. I think it was 2018. But Adam Young, the person that made the Fireflies song, he started a little contest on his own little website. He created a little website for the thing. I don't think the website is up anymore, but basically it was a contest for anyone that made videos to use the songs that Adam Young had made to use it in the background for either documentary or personal videos. And if you wanted to participate in the contest, you had to grab the songs from the repertoire that he published and use them for ambiance in your videos, right? And I think that the prize was money. I don't want to give information that I'm not 100% sure on, but I do remember that the contest was won by these two guys that actually broke into an abandoned park and did a little how do you say that, like the two guys, they went into the abandoned water park. I think it was a water park. Either a water park or a a theme park. And so they broke into the place and started recording around and kinda like documented their adventures and like talked about their findings and used Adam Young's music throughout the whole video, right? Let me actually check one thing. Did I make it this dark when I did his model? GFD. Oh yeah, I did do it this dark. Huh. I thought I didn't do it this dark. It was dark. Cool. Gotcha. I'm not good with memory, so. I love the winning video, personally, from that thing. It was so cool. They honestly deserved the win. Like, the way in which it implemented the music into the video was very nice, very good, you know. Give me a sec. I was replying to a message earlier, and I don't remember if I clicked send or not. I'm so sorry. Where did it go? Wait. Give me a sec. Give me 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds. Here. You know one thing I think is funny? I don't consider myself to be good with computers. And I have a friend that can and will tell you guys, I am not good with computers. I know how to build one. Which is, I don't know, a win, per se? Like, if you give me the parts, I will know which one goes where. I'm not gonna trust myself, because I'm gonna ask other people that know about computers about where do they go, even though deep down I know that they're supposed to go in a certain way. But for some reason, I have found myself in situations where I had to deal with a problem that even the people that I know a lot about computers, were like, how?
Hello, motherfucker.
Hello. Hey, thank you so much for the raid. Thank you so much. No. I'm being attacked by imps. Hope you guys are doing well. Hope you enjoy my ramblings. I was just talking about how I find myself in situations where I find weird issues with my computer. Like, let me tell you. Let me put you in context so that you guys understand what I'm talking about. So, this computer I have, the Windows updated on it. Which is fine, great, right? I never understood Windows updates other than security patches. Those are understandable, but I never paid attention to what is updated, really. But anyway, somehow the audio part was updated in one of these recent updates, right? And that broke my audio. Like, literally, like, my headset stopped working. The computer stopped recognizing my headset. And I didn't do anything. And I don't know. I never unplugged it. I've been using the same headset since I built the computer. Yeah. So I messaged my friend and I'm like, hey, my Windows updated. I think it's, I think that's the reason why, but my Windows updated. And after the update, my mic has stopped working. And my friend was like, how? Like, it didn't happen to my computer. Like, what's going on? And he tried to figure it out. He could not. He gave me all the instructions. Like, he was like, oh, try this. Didn't work. Try this other thing. Didn't work. How about this other thing? Didn't work. Like, any solution that you could think of was not working at all. And then Seether comes over. And Seether is like, what if the issue is not the computer, but the headset? Try connecting your old headset, because I have a tiny old headset. And I look at him and I'm like, if I had to be honest, he's not the smartest with computers, because he grew up with MacBooks. I'm not saying MacBooks are bad, but they're not challenging, if you ask me. That, like, you don't learn much from using a MacBook. I feel like anyone that grew up using Windows only has had some experience with their computer being... you think he's good? He has become better. He has become better. After I moved in with him, now he can build a computer on his own. He knows the computer parts names and what they do, so at least he's not that bad anymore. But what he told me, when he came over and he told me, like, what if the problem is your headset? I looked at him and I'm like, how? Right? How could it be my headset? It's been the same headset since I built the computer, like I said. And I looked at him, but deep down, I had the hunch of, maybe he is right? What if he's right, you know? So, I did what he said. I unplugged the headset I was using, and I connected my old headset. My old headset doesn't have a mic. So I had to go back to using my microphone that is included with my webcam. So the microphone I'm using right now, it's a webcam one. It's not the best, but at least my friends have told me it's good enough, you know. It has a pre-built noise canceling, which is good, and it sounds nice, not gonna lie. But I connected my old headset and it worked. It freaking worked. And the expensive one, the good one, that costed me like, I think it was $65, was not working. The $65 headset was not working, but the $5 one that I got from Five Below was working. And it's been the headset I've been using this whole time. I don't know what Windows did, but it killed that headset after the update. That headset is dead. I have not touched it since I had to switch. Cause I don't know what happened. I went to my friend who knows a lot about computers. He tried to fix it. He could not. I could not. Google could not. No, I didn't disconnect. I switched. I was like, because the computer has two ports, right? It has two ports where you can connect the headset to. I switched port one, did not work. Port two did not work. I have no idea what was wrong with the headset because it was working perfectly, amazingly. It's the sound on that headset is crisp. The microphone on that headset is not the best, but it's pretty good. And I miss it. I miss it so much because I'm not. I noticed the difference between that headset and this one that I have right now. And it's kind of saddening because I was using that headset for so long and I changing to this one was kind of awful because the audio difference between a cheap one and an expensive one is noticeable. Anyone that has bought a better headset at some point can agree with me that like switching to a better headset like is something. Ads? I did not click ads. It might be. Actually, I should sometimes put ads to play, but I forget. But anyway, it happened to me. I haven't seen anyone complain about this though. I wish there were other people going through my same issue. To where I could go into, I don't know, maybe a forum and be like, hey, my headset is not working. My headset is this specific model. Which it has happened before where like I had an issue. And this is another story. I had an issue with a tablet. It was my Wacom tablet. For some reason, Windows 7 was the Windows I had at the time. And Windows 7 hated it. Windows 7 despised my old tablet. Like, it would not work. And I had to configure the tablet every single time I turned on the computer. I had to configure and set it up so that it would work. And it was annoying, not gonna lie. It was very annoying having to deal with it. But eventually a friend of mine told me... I actually had the same problem with the... Oh, yeah. Yeah, it has to do with Windows for some reason. Like, it not finding the tablet? It's a Windows problem. And actually in my case, I did not have the money to buy a brand new tablet, so I had to stick with the whole like turn on the computer, install the tablet, turn off the computer, go back to zero, you know? So next time I had to turn it back on, I had to do the whole installation process again, right? And a friend of mine told me, like, hey, why don't you try changing to Windows 10? And this was back when Windows 10 was still new. It just came out. And I looked at my friend, and he was very techie, you know. And he told me, like, I've heard that Windows 10 is trying to fix issues that with compatibility with old tech. And my tablet was not old, it was just old in terms of it didn't come out with Windows 10. It came out before Windows 10. So I looked at my friend and I was like, maybe Windows 10 could fix my issue. And it did. It did. Changing to Windows 10 made my tablet work. I don't know what it was. It just worked. From one day to the other. Decided to start working. And since then, I have used that tablet for years. Oh, I forgot one detail of this one. I forgot the little purple thing on the middle. And so, yeah, like, I love Windows, but sometimes it does stuff like this that makes you wonder, like, why am I still using you? You know? It's like, I hate you, but I love you, but I hate you. It's not that separated in the back. Let me do it again. It's like this, and then it separates. Yeah. I wonder what the little symbol on his forehead means, if it has any meaning. Does he have any purple anywhere else on the face? Nope, just tip of the ears and the forehead. Gotcha. Let me do it on this one. No, they don't touch. There you go. But, man, I've had so many. Windows do be making faulty things to us. Yeah. Yeah, they do. They try to fix it, though, which is nice. Actually, that reminds me. A friend of mine today, in a local chat we have, he was complaining about his phone. Because his iPhone was blurry on one corner. And he was like, hey, does anyone know what's going on? So I grabbed his message and I just like dissected it. Because if you want to find something on Google, and this is something that they've done for years. Like if you want to find something on Google, you don't put the whole sentence like, my phone is blurry. No, you put iPhone blurry screen, you know, and that will give you better answers, better results, a little bit more obscure results, if that makes sense. And so I did that. I grabbed what my friend said, dissected it, and posted it on Google. And it took me to three websites. The first two were Apple's help website, where it's like, you go there, you ask for help, and hopefully, if you're lucky, someone else had the same issue and they figured out how to fix it. If not, you're on your own, but if someone else had the same issue, they can reply to you and tell you, hey, I've had the same issue, and this is how I fixed it. Hopefully, it works for you too, kind of thing. And I sent my friend whatever these people were saying, like, hey, do this, do that, right? And he tried it. It worked. It fixed it. The thing is, like, turns out there is a bug, and the bug has been existing for years. 4 years on iPhones, where if your iPhone wants to, It's gonna make a corner of your screen blurry, and you cannot see anything. Not even text. You can't see anything on the area. And the only way, there's only two ways of fixing it. The first one is going to your settings, because the bug has to do with your light options, the screen light options. So what you do is you go to your light settings and you turn it off and then turn it back on, and boom, fixed. It doesn't stop it from happening again, but it fixes it in the moment, right? And the second way to fix it is restarting the phone. And Apple has known of this bug since 2020. And their solution has been to not do anything. They don't do anything about it. They're like, oh yeah, we know, it's there. And I'm confused, why? Oh shoot, no, it's streaming as a rerun again? Oh my goodness, I said I was gonna check for it. I mean, I have to stop streaming in a sec because I had to go get lunch. But when I come back, I'm gonna definitely change that. I am. Because, I don't want to,
Thank you, come again.
Hey! Thank you! Have fun eating, thank you. I will. In your honor, I will. Oh, if you're heading to bed soon, yeah, I hope you have sweet dreams. And feel rested. Oh, I have a call. I have literally had to leave right now, but give me one sec.
Stop.
Yeah, but I can't really be on the stream and talk to you at the same time because I want to eat and stuff. But yeah, thank you so much for coming, guys. I will stream back again in like 40 minutes or so. But yeah. Hey, baby, calm down. But yeah, thank you so much. I'll be right back.